Thank you very much, James. James doing what he loves best,
and
watching a game of cricket.
And in beautiful weather, too. Well, we've got 39 days to go in the Great St Swithin prediction, but day one's okay, and I think day two as well, isn't it?
I suspect 3, 4, 5 and 6 might be going the same way,
too. Now, what about this talk of temperatures up in the 30s or 90s?
Could well be. Sunday afternoon. Particularly away from the coast. If you don't like the heat in the next few days, the coast will definitely be the place to be because there's not going to be a lot of cloud around to hide the sunshine. Not so today. We did expect some to come into eastern parts this morning, but made its way rather too far across for some people's liking, all the way to Dorset. And even just after midday here at Worthing, it was rather loath to break up, gave us rather a gloomy morning in some places. And whilst there will be some cloud around first thing tomorrow, it's not going to last very long at all, so lots of sunshine to come during the next few days. Tonight there is some cloud around, and we're certainly going to find some more, just drifting in on those northeasterly breezes, but I would think most of us are actually going to have mostly clear skies, so temperatures taking a bit of a tumble. Nice fresh night, even 10 Celsius in the east under those patches of cloud, as low as 8 in the west, which is 46 Fahrenheit. And the wind should ease down too. There's been quite a brisk northeasterly blowing through today, but that'll be down to a force 4 to 5 by tomorrow morning. Only around 10 to 15 miles an hour overland. Any cloud in the east and the north soon breaking up, and really it's a case of unbroken sunshine through the day tomorrow. Those bright blue skies, very strong sunshine, and in the afternoon in particular it's going to feel very warm indeed in inland parts because the winds by then will be very light. We're going to start to see a sea breeze coming in along the shores. That is southeasterly, fairly steady force 4, so a good breeze if you're thinking of going sailing, but don't forget the sun block because the sun is really strong at this time of year. Somewhere between 20 and 30 minutes is a burn time. Temperatures slightly higher than today, so they managed to get up to 22 in one or two places today, but I would think somewhere between 22 and 24 for tomorrow afternoon, which is up to 75 Fahrenheit. So getting warmer all the time. That certainly continues through the second part of the week and into the weekend. Temperatures nudging up day by day. 28 Celsius by Saturday is 82 Fahrenheit. There will hardly be a cloud in the sky at all.
Thanks, Helen. Going to be hot. Finally tonight, the main news headlines. The Princess of Wales has decided to stop working for 100 charities following her divorce. She says she took the decision with great sadness and could no longer guarantee the level of commitment the jobs needed. The government is lifting restrictions to allow cross-channel ferry companies to work more closely together or even merge. The Consumers Association says it could lead to higher fares and reduced choice, particularly at ports such as Newhaven, Portsmouth and Southampton. And the case of a man accused of stalking a 13-year-old girl has divided the seaside town of Hayling Island in Hampshire. Friends of Stephen Gomes say he's done nothing wrong, but the girl's family claim they may have to leave the area.
That's it from us. We're back, as usual, at the same time tomorrow from the team here. A very good evening.
Good night.
As I walk down the street, seems everyone I meet, each night I hurry to.
This is the type of train highlighted by the report. It was built in the early 1960s. Nothing here is quite what it seems.
Which put a smile on the face of Mr. Sunshine.
Yes, I'm just a lucky soul.
She's got over 500 inmates.
They knew that he would explode again.
Get me back up north to see my family.
A tide of unrest.
We had information there was going to be an escape attempt this week.
And no easy answers.
Not prepared to compromise the security of this jail to get visitors through quickly.
Always trying to get the balance right between security and care.
It's not fiction, but real life drama. Law Women, tonight, 9:30 on BBC One.
Friday night on BBC One, and Gary Barlow will be performing his first solo number one on Top of the Pops, while at 7:30.
Frankenstein is coming to life.
Building bionic humans in Future Fantastic. They're playing the Olympic Game at 8, and Jim Davidson hosts Big Break at 8:30.
Did you put a cat in our freezer?
Victor encounters a very cool cat at 9:30. One in Chicago hope life doesn't come cheap.
Sell my life insurance?
AIDS with meningitis, you could get 60, 70,000 easy.
After the Olympic preview, Mel Brooks appoints a new sheriff in the classic comedy Blazing Saddles. Then at 12:55, we go live to Atlanta for the spectacular opening of the 1996 Olympic Games, right through the night with BBC One.
In half an hour, EastEnders and Pat steals herself for a big day back behind the wheel. Before that, get a mouthful of this.
And on tonight's Good Food Show, there's a distinctly international flavour. I'm allowing myself a little self-indulgence